the Maplewood Marine Restoration Project has restored nearly 5 hectares of nearshore habitat within Burrard Inlet. The site was created through past industrial activities where a large basin was dredged. With very little and low habitat diversity, there wasn't a lot of light that penetrated the basin, so there wasn't vegetation and very little habitat. The project site was identified as a near-shore habitat restoration priority of the Tsleil-Waututh Nation, and we've delivered the project in collaboration with the Tsleil-Waututh Nation. We created a large tidal flat, we restored a tidal flat area, we created a subtidal eelgrass bed, and then a large subtidal rock reef. The habitat is intended to support juvenile salmon, other aquatic species, invertebrates for the benefit of Burrard Inlet. We did hire a shore crew to hand prepare the eelgrass shoots prior to transplant, and we hired Inlewitosh, which is a Tsleil-Waututh owned business, and we had Indigenous community members as part of the shore crew. So we had Tsleil-Waututh members, Squamish members, and also participation from the Musqueam Indian Bed. Annually, we'll be out here monitoring the habitat to ensure that it's meeting its biophysical objectives. We'll be doing this for multiple years in the future. And the lessons learned will inform this project, adaptive management, and it can be applied to other projects. This project had an exceptional and committed multidisciplinary team. I think we're all proud of the end result and also really share in receipt of the Innovation in Sustainability Award from EGBC. The award really aligns with the Port Authority's initiatives and vision for the Port Authority to be the world's most sustainable port. We'd really like to extend our thanks to the Tsleil-Waututh Nation for their collaboration on this project, and to the Musqueam and Squamish Nations for their involvement. Also really want to thank key stakeholders, local residents of the North Shore for their patience and understanding during construction, as well as their involvement through the design, permitting and construction. The project serves as an example of balancing a growing gateway while protecting and restoring nearshore habitat in collaboration with the Tsleil-Waututh Nation.